venture to the deep. And though our senses fail, your graces still prevail, and we become the love that we receive.
Good afternoon. My name is Frank Shenrock. I am a member of the Knights of Columbus Council 140 here in Portsmouth. We are asking for your help for our first annual Corpus Christi Knights of Columbus golf event here at Corpus Christi. We need golfers, sponsors, volunteers, and donations. Anyone can make a donation, even in memory of a loved one. Proceeds will be used to help local nonprofits, such as New Generation for a New Roof, as well as funding certain venues for our parish. The event takes place September 3rd at the Sagamore Hampton Country Club. Details can be found in the bulletin, and we have additional literature in the back of the church. Golfers and donations can also be made at events.golfstatus.com. at the bottom of the brochure. Or you can place them in an envelope and notate it as golf event in the basket. We'll also be available after Mass if you have any questions. Thank you in advance for your support, and we appreciate any help you can give us to help our community. God bless.
As you look through the bulletin, you'll see numerous things that are coming up, previews of those. But I call your attention specifically, we've been announcing that we are going to be having the vocation icon that goes week to week from home to home. Those who receive the icon simply pray for our men and women in formation and those discerning. If you are willing to take a week, there are only the 52 weeks available. The sign-up sheets are in the back of the church in the left-hand corner under the window. Please be sure to print your name and phone number clearly. And the week before the week you chose, you'll get a reminder call. The details are in the bulletin. So thank you in advance for taking the time for not just saying you'd like to have priests and religious, but believing in the power of prayer and welcoming the icon to your home is a great opportunity to do that. Also, this Thursday is a holy day of obligation, the solemnity of the Assumption of the Most Holy Mother of God, and as is our custom, we have three masses, morning, noon, and evening, and those are outlined in the bulletin as well. Lastly, a special word of thanks to those who did so much last Sunday, both in the celebration of the solemn mass with Father Joseph, and then the gathering for fellowship and food and farewell at the parish center. It was a wonderful day for a variety of ages, and it was thanks to numbers of people, again, of a variety of ages pitching in. So thank you so much for that. These are the occasions that really bind us together as a parish family. So I'm very, very grateful. Father Joseph is the celebrant of this Mass today, and then tomorrow we keep him in prayer as tomorrow evening he flies to Rome to begin his new assignment of advanced theological studies. It's been good to have him with us for these past 6 weeks, and we look forward to welcoming him home as he resides here the times of breaks in these coming years. So again, thank you for your support, and all who in addition took the time to write notes and cards to him.
Good afternoon. Would you please join together in singing number 309, here at this table, number 309.
For all of them. of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you. We bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the desert until he came to a broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death, saying, "This is enough, O Lord. Take my life, for I am no better than my father's." He lay down and fell asleep under the broom tree. But then an angel touched him and ordered him to get up and eat. Elijah looked, and there at his head was a hearth cake and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again. But the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him, and ordered, "Get up and eat, else the journey will be too long for you." He got up, ate, and drank. Then, strengthened by that food, he walked 40 days and 40 nights to the mountain of God, Horeb. The word of the Lord.
Answered me and delivered me from
from all my fears. Afflicted man called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. And see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in him. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were sealed for the day of redemption. All bitterness, fury, anger, shouting, and reviling must be removed from you, along with all malice. And be kind to one another, compassionate, forgiving one another, as God has forgiven you in Christ. So be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us as a sacrificial offering to God for a fragrant aroma, the word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to John. The Jews murmured about Jesus because he said, I am the bread that came down from heaven. And they said, is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph? Do we not know his father and mother? Then how can he say, I have come down from heaven? Jesus answered and said to them, stop murmuring among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, they shall all be taught by God. Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the manna that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Gospel of the Lord. Prophet in the first reading grows faint after one day of traveling in the desert, being victorious at Mount Carmel, slaying the 450 false prophets and priests of the idol Baal. He's chased into the desert by Queen Jezebel and her assassins. Seeking to save his life, he thinks he's lost it. Lord, this is enough. This is too much. Just finish it. But God gives him food, this mysterious sustenance by which he is able to walk for a period of time to the mountain of God. There's a biblical imagery of that, which speaks to what God does. And it was a foreshadowing of what he does today. Sustaining us with his grace, enabling us to walk to the mountain of God, heaven. So often in the midst of difficulties, trials, tribulations, or even repeated patterns of sin, we think, Lord, this is too much. This is enough. I can't do anymore. Why won't you take me out of this? Go back to that first reading. Ezekiel receives food, not that rescues him out of the desert, changes it into a lush paradise, but he receives food that strengthens him to walk through that desert. God doesn't rescue us from the trials and tribulations, but he strengthens us to work through them. See, precisely in that act of trust, of handing over the great good of our life, of our loves, our lesser loves to the Lord, in that act of worship, we receive something far greater than we could ever have hoped to offer. We receive God himself. Jesus Christ, and according to our disposition, he strengthens us with food for the journey to heaven. Our happiness, our strength is not found in our ability to pull ourselves up by our own bootstraps, to deal with this difficulty or the other, but rather in trusting in the Lord, that our strength is from him. The people murmured when they heard Jesus say that he is this bread, he is this strength come down from heaven. Oh, I've prayed to Jesus before and I still have this difficulty. I'm still stuck in this pattern of sin. I'm still struggling with X, Y, and Z. Let's go to one of the church fathers, St. John Chrysostom. He mentions that the people, the Jews, murmured about Jesus because their hearts were fixed on material gain. They're fixed on temporal goods, of having everything be all right, good and now. And instead of being focused on the eternal good of the fulfillment of the covenant that God had spoke of down through the ages. And so when we find ourselves at our wits' end, it seems like we can't do anymore, we can't go anymore, just want to give up. What has the attention of our heart? What are our loves? Do we lean into the gift of the Eucharist that flows from having offered everything to God and not holding anything back, saying, "This is enough, Lord. I've given you this, but no more. I've given you one son for the priesthood, but no more for the church. I've given my wife 5 hours, but no more. Oh, I've answered so many questions of my children, but not another. I've answered the same question of my demented parent for the umpteenth time, no more. I can't do it, Lord. This is too tough. Take me out of this." No, he strengthens us so that those little crosses, those repeated patterns of sin, become places that we lean on him and his grace and his love. Do we see in the Eucharist the source and summit of our life, of our existence, as food that strengthens us to live out the demands and dynamics of marriage, of family life, of baptism, of the glory that Christ has ascended to, because he calls you and I to that same glory? The extent to which we find ourselves spinning our wheels or not going anywhere might be the extent to which our hearts and our minds are fixed and preoccupied on temporal things, on lesser goods, instead of the eternal mountain of God, that God himself strengthens us to make that journey. But what are we willing to let go of and hand over? A few things? Is there a limit? Or is it everything, enacted each and every time we come to Mass to worship God and receiving that food that changes us into him more and more? We will be not only taught by God, but we will be indwelling with God as he accompanies us and enables us to get to the mountain of God, even beyond this dark valley and shadow of death. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, for our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With hearts hungering for the bread of eternity, let us call out to our Lord.
For the church, may our word and witness be a compelling invitation for those searching for truth and closer relationship with God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all police officers, firefighters, and those in military service, may they be protected as they daily put themselves at risk in service of others and their safety. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Joseph, as he departs for Rome to begin his time of advanced theological study. May he grow in wisdom and grace and be enriched to enrich the lives of others. We pray to the Lord. For those who are exploited, addicted, cast aside, and not valued, may the dignity of every human person be respected and defended, including the most innocent preborn children who are considered intrusions. We pray to the Lord. For our departed loved ones, especially Helena and Bill Nyland, for whom this Mass is offered, and for all who die through violence or neglect, we pray to the Lord. For the needs in our hearts today, we pray to the Lord.
Father, hear the prayers of your children who call out to you in faith, and grant what we ask, if it be for your glory and our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Would you please join together in singing number 356, Ubi Caritas, number 356.
Thank you. pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raise up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord.
death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
4:2.
I will reign.
Let us pray. May the communion and your sacrament that we have just consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It's a quick word of thanks to all of you for all your prayers and all of your gifts and your cards and well wishes as I take this next step in my vocation in being a priest for the Diocese of Manchester. Know that I'll bring each and every one of you to all the particular and privileged altars that are in the eternal city and throughout Italy. I'll be bringing you, as it were, on my back to the altar, lifting you up in prayer. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Please join together in singing number 430. I sing the mighty power of God, number 430.